It is my pleasure to open the conference on behalf of the South African International Maritime Institute. But also I come here bringing the greetings of my university, Nelson Mandela University, for the successful conference. Over the next 1.5 days, we will explore the challenges of the capacity of our education and training system to meet the skills needs of the maritime sector. We all know that the ocean's economy holds significant potential for economic growth and job creation in our country. The potential contribution of about 177 billion to the GDP and up to 1 million direct jobs by the year 2033 are well known and publicized estimates that initially informed Operation Pakisa in the ocean's economy 5 years ago. The challenge remains, however, how do we shift the output of our education and training system to provide the skills in demand in all subsectors in the maritime economy? It is not really a case of merely numbers, these colleagues. It is the need for people with the right types of knowledge, skills and attitudes that will enable industry to take advantage of opportunities for growth because they have the capacity to do so. A critical element is ensuring that our graduates are future fit, are flexible, they are adaptable to learn new skills, to reskill and take on new types of jobs or become entrepreneurs. This is critical as the fourth industrial revolution transforms the way we do business, the way we manufacture goods, the way we supply services, and the way we deliver education and training. Operation Pakisa sets targets for the numbers of skilled people needed in the subsectors that formed part of the initiative, including aquaculture, maritime transport, manufacturing, offshore oil and gas exploration, marine protection, and ocean governance. Coastal and marine tourism and small harbors development have since been added to the sectors for development under Operation Pakisa, and we are also working with the fishing industry to develop the skills that are needed there. Targets based on forecasts and estimates are all very well, but there is a need to get down to identifying specific needs and looking at whether our education institutions are appropriately equipped to develop and deliver the academic and vocational programs needed, and if not, how to support them in order for them to do so successfully. SAIMI's mandate from the Department of Higher Education and Training is to develop the National Maritime Skills Framework, Strategy and Implementation Plan, thus understanding the supply and demand environment, the capacity and the constraints, and how to equalize supply side output with market demand will continue to be critical to our work as SAIMI. The work of our Operation Pakisa Skills Working Groups has advanced in that regard, with skills audits and needs analysis completed in most of the lab areas. This information will therefore assist in revising targets when necessary, so that plans to address priority, scarce and critical skills needs can be implemented. SAIMI also commissioned the Oceans Economy Skills Development Assessment for South Africa. This was to build on the work previously done in determining the capacity of our education and training institutions to deliver the skills forecast as being needed for maritime economic growth. A key finding of that study was that our post-school education institutions are producing graduates with maritime-related qualifications in sufficient numbers. However, the types of skills being produced are not in alignment with the needs of the market. This requires not just a shift in the types of qualifications being offered or the content of the curricula, but also shifts at policy and regulatory level to ensure that institutions have requisite capacity in terms of people, facilities and equipment to deliver the needed skills for our country. That study forms the basis of this conference and also our ongoing engagements with industry bodies to turn focus into clear targets and plans for how to meet them. SAIMI's key role, as I move to conclude, and strategic intention is to work in partnership with role players to play a facilitating role in ensuring dialogue between industry and the education and training sector. This includes both education providers and the regulatory authorities who play an enabling role in ensuring that our institutions can offer the programs and qualifications needed and that they are equipped indeed to do so. Our intention with this conference in taking this critical work forward is to emerge here from the conference with a clearer strategy and a better understanding of how we will work together to redirect the skills development initiatives in the sector for better outcomes and better impact. I hope that in the next couple of days, the conference delegates from industry will enlighten the gathering on the challenges faced in acquiring the skilled people needed to grow the sector. On part of the post-school sector, I hope the conference will seek to explore blockages in the education and training system, the challenges in training sufficient artisans, how to build the capacity of the TVET sector to play a more effective role in maritime skills development. That input will go towards actionable outputs from the conference, a plan to address the challenges for SAIMI to take forward, working in concert with all of you. On behalf of SAIMI, a warm welcome to you all, and as I open the conference, we are looking forward to a conference that is participative, that is interactive, that is engaging, that is generative, and above all, that will lead to improving the conditions for doing business in the maritime economy. It is my humble honor, therefore, to officially open this conference. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much.